Hi, today I will explain Cre-Lox recombination model to knock out a gene. Cre-Lox recombination model is an important tool for studying a gene function by knocking out the gene of interest. The key component of this model are two. First is called Cre-recombinase, and Cre-recombinase is function to recombine LoxP site, and the second part we call LoxP1. LoxP1 is a site of 34 base pair which have 13 plus 8 plus 13 base pair. This 13 and 13 are palindromic region, and this 8 are just random base pair. So this Cre-recombinase can recombine LoxP sites, and they can excise this LoxP site. If I want to show shortly, if that is LoxP1 and that is another LoxP1, and if this is gene means that is target gene. So if you say the gene is X, so this LoxP1 can be recognized by Cre enzyme. This will recognize this region and this region, and it will cut or it will recombine this region, and the function of this gene will be deactivated, or it will just exist from the promoter or from the chromosomal region. That's how knocked out a gene. The Cre-recombinase and LoxP1 both part are not exist in any mammal. These Cre and Lox parts are eligible for bacteriophage. That's actually called P1, that is bacteriophage P1. For studying or making Cre-Lox model, a mouse is engineered with Cre recombinant. For example, this mouse has Cre enzyme under a specific promoter or whatever else, and another mouse which is a target gene, we call it X. This is our gene of interest, and we want to know the function of this gene. So this gene is normally exist in mouse, but by engineering we inserted LoxP site. This is called LoxP, that is called LoxP. So first mouse is engineered with Cre enzyme, and the second mouse is engineering with LoxP to flank the gene of our interest. Here is X, that is called actually floxed, F-L-O-X-T-E-D. That means our gene X is flanked by two floxp region. So when these two mice are breeding together, the ultimate progeny might have this will have Cre and as well as our specific gene. I know my drawing is very bad, and the LoxP. If somehow something's added or somehow Cre gene is activated, so it will transcribe to Cre recombinase enzyme, then Cre-recombinase enzyme will delete this LoxP site. So it will be flanked like this, LoxP. So this will be recombined and gene X will be deleted, and this whole thing will be done by Cre enzyme. That is how it works. So here Cre recombinase will be activated by a specific chemical or environmental signal, or it may be constitutively active in a specific tissue. And once this Cre is activated or it transcribed, then it will target the LoxP site, and once it targets the LoxP site will be flanked or excised, and ultimately the function of gene X will not be seen. And people generally use a reporter gene to see whether this recombination model works or not. That's why they usually put another marker we call a reporter gene. For example, if a reporter gene, they used yellow fluorescence protein. So now it will express YFP, and you will see fluorescence of YFP. So it means that this gene is knocked out and YFP is expressed, because when Cre gene is activated, that means this gene is going to be deleted and YFP will be expressed, because these are under the same promoter. For example, this may be any kind of promoter. I'm not going to explain about this. So why this important? Well, the Cre recombination model is important specifically for studying a gene or function of a specific gene. But as you know, we have many other options, like what we call classical knocking out model. So why we are not using classical model? Why we should interest for a LoxP recombination model? Well, there may have three approach in classical gene knockout model. First of all, it's called embryonic knockout model. So when we deleted a gene in embryonic stage, this may be lethal and mouse may not be survived, and you will not have ultimate any answer because the mouse is dead. So second option, maybe deletion of this gene is not lethal, but as we know, our cells know how to adapt for a stress or response. So cell may have any compensatory pathway, that's why you may not able to see the effect of deletion of that specific gene. And third possibilities is that when you're knocking out a gene, you knocked out globally. I'm talking about embryonic level. So but sometimes we may have interest on lungs or kidney or lymphocytes. So it doesn't matter whether you deleted that gene in other part. So we need to specifically delete in lymphocytes or kidney or lungs. That's why Cre-Lox model is important. So Cre-Lox model is specifically important for site-directed mutagenesis or site-specific deletion of gene. And as I saw the model how it works, so one can easily flank the gene and can delete that gene for the specific purpose. So only flanked a gene, it doesn't mean that this gene is deleted. Unless the Cre recombinase is not activated, the flanked gene will not be deleted. So the major portion is that how you Cre model or Cre recombinase is working, whether it may be under the control of promoter region, or it may be activated by a drug or environmental factor. So the bottom line is that you have to activate Cre enzyme, and this Cre enzyme will ultimately delete your target gene, because the target gene is already flanked by LoxP sites. That's it.